Rapid questions over the nature and motive for the disbursement at the Senate. Senator Medium Defensor Santiago wants the COA to conduct a deeper probe into Enrile's income. But the COA concedes the law gives the Senate President discretion over the use of Senate savings. Meantime, the COA is also looking into unrecorded remittances various government agencies made to the GSIS. So joining us for more on these matters is COA Chairperson Grace PULIDO-TAN. Chairperson, good morning. Thanks for coming over.
Good morning, Pinky. My pleasure.
Hey, do you have your hands full? I mean, this story came out, I would probably say Tuesday or Wednesday last week.
Mm-hmm.
And you've issued a statement that what the Senate President did is above board.
Did I use the term above board? I said that it is authorized by law.
Okay.
Yes.
So I guess, you know, it doesn't make it illegal then, right? It doesn't make it illegal under the law because it's authorized by the law.
Yes, and I'm referring to the General Appropriations Act, the GAA,
right,
which is actually the budget enacted into law by Congress, and it's also Congress who fixes the appropriation per agency, including the budget of the House of Representatives and the Senate.
Correct. And, you know, just to be frank about it, it seems that this has been the practice for a very long time.
Which one? Giving away from bonuses?
Using savings and realigning them in the budget.
Yes. Every year, if we look at all the GAAs, year in, year out, nandun yung mga special provisions na yon.
Is there something wrong with that?
How can I say there's something wrong if the law allows it?
Mm-mm.
You know, we go by what is authorized by law.
Mm-hmm.
Now, of course, a lot of quarters are saying it is immoral, it is unconscionable, it is kahindik-hindik and all of that. But it's not for us to judge. I think that the senators are in the best position to judge for themselves if how is 1.6 million or 250,000 or 600,000 in the scheme of things.
Yeah.
I mean, among them senators, kasi I'm sure that nagkaroon naman ng pamantayan ng Senate President, no? I'm not into the politics here, but I'm sure that how much work did this particular senator do? Was it some, you know, all of that. Like any other boss, I would say, no? Pag nagbibigay ng mga bonuses, meron ka siyempre mga parang kumbaga performance measures, no? And that is not for us to question. Pero ang maganda dito, Pinky, kasi unang-una, gusto kong i-assure din ang ating mga mamamayan that while we are very positive, I'm very sure that the law allows this kind of thing to happen, hindi ibig sabihin na tapos na yung usapin na yan.
Okay.
Because as far as we're concerned, tuloy-tuloy ang audit namin. Ano ang tinitingnan namin? Totoo nga bang savings yan?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you know, because they claim it to have been disbursed from savings.
Yeah.
Ito nga bang savings? Makikita natin yan. At tinitingnan namin ito taon-taon, Pinky. That's the role of our resident auditor in the Senate.
Auditor over the Senate,
okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Ang sinasabi, eh, baka naman daw na kompromiso na ang aming auditor sa Senado, no? Kasi nabibiyayaan din siya.
Or baka takot.
Wow, if that were true, whoever knows na nakompromiso na whatever, please let me know. I'll be the first to discipline him.
Uh-huh.
At kung takot naman, wala akong problema na palitan siya ng isang matapang. But I don't think that it has anything to do with takot eh.
Well, how many resident auditors do you have at the
Senate? We have one resident auditor there, the supervising auditor, and there is a team. There's a staff there. We have a small office in the fifth floor of the Senate.
Uh-huh.
At sa lahat ng mga ahensya ng gobyerno, meron talaga kami opisina. At meron totoo, no? I will concede na may mga kumisa natatakot, pero hindi ko masyadong problema yung mga natatakot. Ang nagiging problema ko, yung mga may modus vivendi, no? At wala rin akong hesitation na tanggalin sila, no? In fact, nung Friday, I did the general reshuffle, so nationwide, maraming mga umikot, no? I just cannot remember kung inikot namin yung aming auditor sa Senado, but kung hindi man, siguro dahil wala pa naman siyang tatlong taon, at wala naman siyang pinapakita o nakikita ko na rason kung bakit ko siya ililipat. But if some quarters or even some of the senators themselves will tell me that our auditor is playing footsies, please give me the lowdown, give me the dossier, and I'll definitely do something about it.
Let me know the suspicion. Give me some evidence.
Oh yes.
And you wouldn't, blink an eye.
I will not mind doing what I have
but
to do.
But that's the standard practice, right, Chairperson? Every 3 years, they actually do a rotation.
By regulation of the COA, yes, pero hindi na susunod. Mm-hmm. Nung pumasok ako, ang dami talaga nag-overstay.
Yeah, so, especially the ones in the army.
The military, the military. So, yun ang mga inuna namin. Yung ginawa ko nung Friday, kumbaga ito na yung mga naiwan.
Yeah.
Na rinigudo na namin lahat, lalo na kasi mag-eleksyon. Mm-hmm. And also, I want to say it again na for the election period, yung aming focus naman sa local governments, binabantayan namin, para malaman ng lahat, no? Binabantayan namin yung mga fund transfers,
okay,
yung mga ghost employees, kasi kung minsan nagbo-bloat, napapansin namin nagbo-bloat yung plantilla ng mga local governments, no? So tinitingnan po natin yun.
That's
tsaka
very important.
Yung election spending, kasi ang daming mga election paraphernalia, okay lang, basta wag nilang galawin ang pera ng bayan.
Okay, balikan lang natin what you were saying, that it was within the bounds of law. It says here that, actually, I think this came from you, ma'am, the GAA, or GAA 2012, Article 4 of the Constitution, authorizes the Senate President and the House Speaker to augment any item in the General Appropriations Law for their respective offices from any savings in other items of their respective appropriations.
Correct.
That's what you're using.
Correct.
Let me bring
Correct.
This in, though. Uh-huh. Senator Miriam Defensor Santiago is saying this. If there is so much savings, if this has been happening from way back at the time of President Cory, Ramos, Estrada, Gloria Macapagal-Arroyo, now Aquino, if this is actually what happens, why can't the resident auditor recommend the reducing of the budget, for example, of the Senate? If you're saving, for example, let's put it year-end, 2 million for every senator, let's put it at 36 million pesos, ma'am, at the least.
Mm-mm.
Pwede ba yun?
Pwede kaming mag-recommend ng ganon, but I would say that is in the extreme. In an extreme scenario, no? For example, nagre-recommend kami kung ang isang government corporation palugi ng palugi year in and year out, definitely i-recommend namin na tingnan nyo nga, baka dapat nang isara yan. Okay? Pero pag yung tungkol sa budget, kasi that's government loss na talaga eh. Etong sa budget, yun kasi ang inappropriate naman ng batas sa kanila, no? So in a sense, talagang dapat nilang gastusin yon, no? Because yun ang nakatalaga para sa kanila,
mm-hmm,
na budget na yon. So, gastusin man nila yon, talagang yun ang gagawin nila, hindi lugi sa gobyerno yon. Okay, that's one reason why we are not too jumpy about recommending to that effect.
Okay.
On the other, it's really the DBM who has the oversight on all these things. Yung Department of Budget natin.
Yes.
And under the law,
I will agree with you there.
Yeah, the bad DBM. At saka, nasa batas din na kung yung mga gamit nila ng mga ganyang savings, rini-report yan sa DBM. Nakikita ng DBM yan.
Yeah. But what about your thoughts possibly on savings being brought to the National Treasury, something like that?
Because yes, some agencies naglalapse yung kanilang allocation kasi hindi nila namamalayan, hindi nila din ino-obligate, hindi nagagastos, automatic reversion to the Treasury.
Mm-hmm.
Yung mga iba naman, kasi sa totoo lang, no, I mean, from what we see, a lot of government agencies have savings, but not much. So, pag ganyan, rinirealign sa PS, most of the time, pinapamigay talagang bonus ng mga empleyado.
So, ganun talaga? That's practice? Okay.
Yung siguro sa Senado, nagkakaroon lang siguro ng how do you call that? It's in the limelight because Senator Santiago drew our attention to it,
mm-hmm,
drew
mm-hmm
the public's attention to it. The amount, the absolute amount is kind of large. Even if you're talking 1.6 per senator, there are 23 senators.
Actually, let's clarify that now. Uh-huh. It's really not 1.6. It's over 2 million because it's 600,000. He gave out 600,000 in November, 1.3 in December. Mm-hmm. So, I'm sorry, 1.6 in December. Mm-hmm. It's about 2.2 million pesos for each senator, yes, except the four.
Yeah. So, yun, medyo, if you look at the absolute amount, medyo malaki, diba? Tsaka, end of the year, sabi nga nila, ano pang gagawin nila dun sa pera na yun, ano? Baka naman meron ng mga na-obligate, kailangan ng cash ngayon para mabayaran. That is also another possibility. That's why I said, hindi pa tapos ang usapin na ito insofar as we're concerned because there are still a lot of things that we need to look into. We have just settled at this point in time. Is the Senate President authorized to do that under the law?
The
answer is yes. Mm-hmm. Was it in fact used in accordance with the requirements of law? Was it put into those items of expenditure for which it was meant? Like, kung MOOE yan, napunta ba yan? Ganon. So, matitingnan din
yan ang lahat dyan. Because correct. A lot of them, di pa ata nagagamit
Totoo. Okay. So, lalabas po yung audit report namin, usually in the middle of the following year. So, 2013 will be, ano, June. 2012, no? At which leads me to another thing, which for me, maganda ang nagiging nangyayari dito kasi parang there are information that we're getting, no? from comments, from the public, from the senators themselves na itong mga pondo na to, MOOA, pero hindi naman talaga nagagastos ng lahat. Wow, I want to know ano ba talaga, no? Kasi ang mga senators, no? When they liquidate, for example, they usually just give a certification on their honor. They're saying that, yes, we spent this money for this kind of thing. And kung may mga dokumento kami nakikita, well and good.
Wala resibo, ma'am?
Walang resibo. Hindi required
in effect. So talagang
ano
lang certification?
Certification.
For the MOOE?
On their honor. Parang, it's by Senate.
So it's like you're pledging that I'm telling you the truth, the whole truth, and nothing. Ganon. Mm-mm. I see. Okay.
Mm-mm. So,
that's how they liquidate that?
Yes, they liquidate advances in that manner. And sa akin naman, dinatnan ko na yung practice na yan, ano? At sa akin naman, who am I naman to question the integrity and honor of our senators?
No.
But now that I am hearing all these things, siguro it will help if they give us concrete examples. Yeah. Yeah. For example, mm-hmm. Senator Santiago is one of those who's been saying something to that effect. And then maybe if the Honorable Senator can help us out, and so we can come up with a benchmark of how much exactly is it talaga on a typical basis, makikita namin ano usually ang mga gastusin ng mga ating mga senador.
Let's clarify.
Diba? Ibe-benchmark natin yon kay Senator Santiago because I think Senator Santiago is really the one who's so passionate about getting to the bottom of these things. And I really appreciate that. Thank you very much, Senator Santiago.
So ganito.
Please help us.
Chairperson, let's talk about the 2 million, for example, if we're talking about that for now. What you're saying is, after being given 2.2 million pesos as additional MOOE, all the senators have to do is submit a certification to your office saying that I use this for this purpose, etc., etc. That's it.
If it is in the nature of a cash advance, yung pagbibigay, no?
Hindi, like the MOOE that Senate President...
Hindi ko kasi masabi ngayon, Pinky, kung yon e binigay sa pangalan ng ating senador o binigay sa kanyang opisina, iba yun
They told me it's the office, ma'am.
Kasi kung opisina, yung opisina i-audit namin. Hindi parang cash advance ni Mr. Senator yon. Kasi opisina,
that's why...
Pero titingnan din natin ano ba ang documentation
Okay. That's why Senator Cheese was saying, I spoke to him, ma'am, it's going to be liquidated, he says, he claims, as he always does, under COA rules. For example, ma'am, he says, we can't use that, we can only use that for office expense, machines, papers, meetings, additional meetings, etc. Ganun lang daw yun. But it cannot be used for restaurants, drinking, going out, ganyan. Okay, so I remember specifically he said, it was, the check was for the office of the senator, the senator. Mm-mm. So there are two different things that we need to understand here. Okay.
Ngayon, kung ang ginawa ni Senator Cheese, example lang po Senator Cheese, no? From that money, nag-cash advance siya, no? Ili-liquidate niya yon.
Okay, I understand it now. All right, so that's a good thing to, you know, at least that makes me understand that better. Let's talk about this, what Senator Santiago is saying. should the not COA enumerate what savings are valid?
Okay.
What are savings that are valid?
Alam mo, yan pang isang ano, no? Kasi the term savings and the authority given to the Senate President and to the Speaker of the House to augment appropriation from any savings came from the Congress. Yung mga mambabatas natin.
That's right.
So, sila po sana ang magsabi sa amin, ano ibig nilang sabihin ng savings? Mm-hmm. Bakit kami?
It would be very unfair for you to actually identify what savings are
exactly.
when you didn't.
Why should we second guess them?
That's right.
Eh, sila ang nagsabi na, oh, pwede, basta gamitin savings. Mm-mm. So, ano po ibig sabihin ng savings? Please specify.
Pero ang hirap, no, Chairperson, when you think about it, Congress made that, should clarify what savings are.
Yes.
And yet, at the end of the day, sila din man talaga nakikinabang
yes,
dito
yes,
eh. Di ba? So, it
maganda nga yun kung meron kaming panuntunan, di ba? Like a benchmark. What is it really? What are the parameters of savings?
Mm-hmm.
Because right now, what we're going by when we do savings is the simple savings in mathematics.
Yeah,
you have
yeah.
your appropriations.
Yeah.
Etong naging allotment mo from the DBM. Etong inobligate mo. Ibig sabihin, ito yung mga ginastos
expenses.
Mo na o panggastos pa. So, ano naiwan? Hindi yun ang savings. Sa amin, yun ang simple.
Mm-hmm.
Now, unless the senators or the Congress has another idea or intention or meaning for that word savings, then please let us know.
Right.
I think it's not fair for us to usurp the prerogative of Congress to define what savings are because they are the ones who said that to use the term and authorize the use of savings.
I guess the problem, Chairperson, is that sometimes to the minds of many, the 2 million is almost like what? An additional pork barrel. They get 200 million pesos a year in pork barrel and an additional 2 million last year. Although this has been the practice for some time, Senate President said he did this since he was actually Senate President. Let's add this. Senator Miriam Defensor Santiago said COA should upload on the internet the potential income of the following, not just their salaries, but also other sources of income. There are a lot. President, Vice President, Senator, congressmen, cabinet members, armed forces, etc. There is, this is what she wants, ma'am. Look into the basic salary, the Christmas and other bonuses, okay? Monthly honoraria for committee work. Malaki daw yan. Monthly appropriation to spend at the senator's discretion for staff salaries and for maintenance and MOOE. Appropriations for consultants, foreign travel funds, and other expenses. That's what I understood.
Okay. We have, we publish every year the ROSA. I think that at one time napag-usapan din natin yan, di ba? Ang kapal-kapal noon, no? So, nandun yon, nandun lahat ng ating mga, at least the top government officials, government corporations kasama. So, nandun nga yung ating basic salary, nandun yung kanilang mga rata, kung ano pa allowances, committee or per diems,
travel,
etc. Nandun lahat yon, ano?
Right.
Sa Senado, meron din. So, meron din yon. In fact, pinapublish pa namin sa dyaryo yung sa Senado at saka sa Kongreso. Okay? I think ang hindi lang napapublish sa dyaryo would be the sa appropriation. I'm sorry, their per diem or honoraria sa kanilang mga committee. Okay? And nakalagay naman dun sa aming ano that this does not include
that.
Okay.
Okay.
Nakalagay doon, nakadisclose yun. Kasi ganun yung naging patakaran noon, ano, and which is why we're reviewing in the same way that we did some changes on the ROSA na siguro sa susunod kukumpletuhin na talaga namin yung mga columns na yon for publication in the newspaper. But nonetheless, maski wala sa dyaryo, accessible yan as a matter of public record sa office ng aming auditor kasi they're supposed to have all of that information.
Mm-hmm.
And the senator, Senator Santiago, being a member of Congress, of being a member of the Senate, can at any time, you please, feel free to do that po. I mean, we will be glad to give you all of that information. But then again, as I was saying earlier, natutuwa naman ako at sana nga matulungan kami ni Senator Santiago dito dahil ngayon lang ako nagkakaroon ng mga concrete information na may mga discretion pala dyan, that the MOOE and things like that are very fluid in a way. Oh, please let us know para matingnan ho nating mabuti and maybe we can start with the with Senator Santiago herself because she knows
she's got a lot to share, definitely.
Yes, she definitely.
What about, I'm sure this is not new to you, ma'am, the fact that some of them would actually not fill up vacancies or not buy certain equipment just to be able to have savings at the end of the year?
You mean the agencies?
The Senate, for example, I remember even the Senator Santiago said that. Na, you know, some people, they manipulate the books. They don't fill up vacancies. They don't buy the necessary equipment in order to have the savings at the end of the year and then distribute it amongst.
Sino yun? Sino yun? Gusto kong malaman. Ma'am, sabihin mo po sa amin. Pero again, let me go back to the law. Ang nakalagay doon, again, it is the Senate President who's authorized to fix and determine the salaries, allowances, bonuses of members, of staff, of even consultants. No? Yeah. So, I think yung mga ganyan, tama eh na i-bring to the attention of the Senate President. Mm-hmm. Until the time that we get all the information, COA is just oversight.
Yeah. And you can just really say that there seems to be a problem here. So-and-so did not liquidate this in accordance with COA rules.
Then, ito pa, pag merong kaming findings na ganon, we also give that recommendation to the Senate President for him to implement.
Ah, I see.
So wala talaga kaming, wala talaga kaming coercive powers.
Wala, you can just recommend.
Yes.
That's why the Senator was saying, Senator Santiago was saying, maybe you can recommend the reduction of the budget since there are always savings on a yearly basis at the Senate, right? But then, you know, it comes to mind, ma'am, the problem of, for example, MWSS back then when, you know, we found out that there were so many bonuses and et cetera. And then you have other agencies na yung kanila pong mga empleyado, at talaga ang late-late ng sweldo, 20 years na po silang nandyan. And then, here comes something like this. Kaya nga sabi nila, lahat daw ng nasa Senado, masaya noong Christmas.
Alam mo, isa pa yan, no? Kailangan siguro malaman din ng ating mga kababayan. Iba-iba kasi ang batas na umiiral para sa different branches of government. When we talk of the executive offices, ang dami talagang restrictions. Mm-hmm. Okay? Either by law or by administrative issuance by the president himself or by
That's
the DBM.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Ang dami talaga.
And it could vary from one
it
president
vary
to
from,
another.
Yes, okay. Yes, yes, no. Sa transportation na lang, sa traveling na lang, ano? Yeah. Ilan lang ang pwedeng mag-business class dyan. Karamihan, kailangan, kailangan economy ka. Tapos ang baon mo, ganito lang, ano? Pati nga kami, nasasakop din ng ibang administrative issuances, eh. Kung kagaya ngayon, gusto namin sanang bumili ng isang man lang na kotse na medyo maayos-ayos para pag may mga bisita, eh, hindi naman yung aming mga Innova ang ginagamit, ano? Halimbawa, darating yung Auditor General ng Japan, ng yung mga trip ng Innova, right. Ba naman ang So, meron naman kaming budget, may kakayanan.
Ang pero, ginagawa niyo, rent a car?
Magre-rent a car ka, but you know, at the end of the day, it will be cheaper if you have, no? Because you can use it for other visitors, no? Yes, we have to go to the office of the president to get an exemption para makabili kami ng isang kotse na may over 2.2 liters ba ang displacement, engine displacement. May mga ganun eh.
Okay.
What I'm saying, the reason why I'm making this as an example is ganon kabusisi, ganon kadetalyado ang mga limitations sa spending generally sa executive department.
Exactly.
Pero co-equal kasi ang Senado, meron din silang mga rules. And then there's another co-equal branch, which is the judiciary.
It's as if too bad for you, ma'am. Because very strict yung rules yung sa executive. I guess that's how I'd see it. Because if I was part of the COA, and just to buy a nice car for, you know, guests and, you know, possible times that you might actually need it, you have to go through a needle in a haystack,
yes,
that type of thing. And then in the Senate, you have, you know, senators getting 2 million just like that.
Yes. But ganun ang batas eh.
Exactly. They did not violate anything. That's why too bad for you. Napaka-stricto lang.
We'll just have to follow.
Yeah. I mean, you know. Sayang.
Ganun lang.
Well, all right. Okay. But you are still, you know, the senator was asking for you to dig deeper into this. A lot of probably, yun na nga, not filling up vacancies. That's not a good thing because it's as if you don't really have a ghost employee, but what you're really doing is you're not filling up a vacancy so you can have that extra money at the end of the year. The numbers, the second question I wanted to ask you, ma'am, is there anything COA can do? For example, there's obviously savings from Senator Aquino's office, and then he became president. Bakit kaya hindi nire-reduce na yan on a yearly basis since he was president in 2010?
Ay, hindi na namin masasagot yan. Kasi diba? DBM na ang proseso kasi, ang budget, DBM will recommend
yes.
to the Senate, to Congress. No? At ang nangyayari nga dyan, lahat ng ahensya ng gobyerno, binubusisi ang budget na rin-recommend mm-hmm. ng DBM. So lahat kami, we go through committee hearings of both the House and yeah. the Senate, yeah. no? Tapos meron kaming plenary at talagang madugong proseso 'yan, you know, sa lahat ng mga kailangan naming gawin. That's one of the things that I wish I didn't have to do, but I have to go through it anyway. So, I suppose that the same perspicacity, the same scrutiny that the House and the Senate do to the budget of all the other
then
agencies,
they should do the same for themselves, ma'am.
Yes,
diba?
Yes.
I mean, you know, you hear of so many agencies saying, ito lang ang budget nila for the year, let's say, 100 million. How am I going to work? For example, what was that agency? If I'm not mistaken, ma'am, it's the PCGG.
Mm-mm.
They have an annual budget of, if I'm not mistaken, it was like 92 million pesos mm-mm, a year. Mm-mm. And when you think about it, you're going to have to go through a lot of court procedures, hiring lawyers, etc., you know, trying to get the best out of the, you know, the lawyers we have here in the Philippines, maybe even litigations abroad. And they have a 92 million peso yeah. budget, and yet, you know, something like this, talagang nakakalaki ng mata for some people, na kayo ang dali-dali ng 2 million sa inyo. Taon-taon.
Oo, maalala ko nung huling budget deliberation namin, kasabay namin si Chairman Eta Rosales ng CHR.
Aliit din ang budget.
Oo, tapos nga, ito, nakakatawa kasi, nauna siya, tapos ako, I think she was asking for an additional 5 or 50 million. I'm not too sure now, but nandun sa multiples na yon. Halos umiiyak na siya, nagpa-plead, hirap na hirap na mag-justify
yeah.
ultimo sentimo ng bakit ganito, kasi ilang numbers of ganyan. Basta may mathematical, ano siya, prinisinta niya yon. Kaya nga nung after the budget hearing, sabi ko, Chair naman, nakukonsyensya naman ako sa ginagawa mo na ano na panghingi ng budget, o nakukonsyensya ako, sabi ko, kasi kami medyo malaki-laki ang budget namin ano compared to them, ano.
Well,
but we go through that okay.
Chairperson, very quickly, let's talk about what was in the papers today. There was a report on agencies whose GSIS receivables showed the biggest irregularities. Let's talk about this
very
briefly.
What do you mean, the GSIS receivables, yung mga hindi nagre-remit?
Yes, yes.
Yes, maraming ahensya ang hindi talaga nagre-remit.
Ito, top one, ma'am. GSIS record showed SSS has a balance of 1.184 billion.
That's very possible, yes. I mean, if we look at the records, of course, I cannot validate the figures now, but is it a matter of fact? Does it happen? Yes, I confirm.
But that's so much, ma'am. 1.1 billion.
Kaya nga ngayon, maraming mga ahensya na ngayon ang naglilinis kasi nga fina-follow up namin. You see what happened, Pinky, was year in, year out, nandun yan sa mga findings namin, recommendation namin, ganito na gawin ninyo.
But,
linisan nyo na. But then, the next year comes, it's not nalinis, nadagdagan pa.
Tatama.
Okay? So, as of 2011, talagang wow, ang lalaki ng mga balanse. So, we're trying
but
to...
But what can be done?
Tinutulungan na namin sila maglinis, you know? Uh-huh. Because sometimes, it's a matter of people not doing what they need to do.
People simply, not remitting what they're supposed to be remitting.
Simply just the recording. Some they don't even have a full grasp of their accountabilities. So, tinutulungan na namin silang mag-pencil push
Mm-mm.
para malaman, right. magkaalaman na talaga magkano at nang
okay.
mairemit na ang problema sa mga ibang ahensya. Since ang tagal ng mga may mga accountabilities, kulang na sila ngayon ng pera pang pondo.
So, yung mga tao dati, wala
oh,
na.
Oh, That's another problem.
Okay, uh-oh. Number one was, just to give the viewers a brief background, number one is SSS. Number two is the Quezon City government. Number three, Philippine Navy, Pasay City, National Center for Mental Health, NFA, National Food Authority, Philippine Orthopedic Center, etc. There are a number of them listed by the COA, the Commission on Audit. All right, so at least we got that covered, ma'am, very briefly, and we got to talk a lot about the cash bonuses. You know, they don't even want to call it a bonus. They just want to call it an additional MOOE. Mm-hmm. So we have the COA that will be on top of this situation. I wonder if Senator Miriam Defensor Santiago will meet with you guys
to iron this out. I really need her help. Yeah.
All right. I think it's not just Senator Santiago. Also, it was also Senator Ping Lacson and Senator Honasan also wanting to look into this practice of additional MOOEs. Chairperson Grace Pulido-TAN.
Thank you so much.
I know you're very busy.
Thank you. It's been a while
since I last saw you. Thanks for coming
thank
over.
Thank you. Our pleasure. Thank you, Pa.
The Golden Globe Awards are underway and the U.S. is dealing with a flu outbreak. This and more when Mornings at ANC returns.